All right, we're going to build a fitness website. So let's start out by, let's run a couple laps. No, I'm just kidding about that. All right. We can just pretend we did that. All right. One of the things I said is that if I'm building a website and I'm going to use server-side scripting at all, I will use it for every page. So in other words, you could build a site that was a mix of HTML and PHP pages. But if I'm going to use PHP, I'm going to use PHP completely. In fact, I would use PHP even if I didn't have anything that really required it. All right, I would always use a server-side scripting language for several reasons. One of them, if I ever wanted to add something in that was server-side scripting, I wouldn't like to have to go and rename stuff. The other thing is through the use of what are called include files. And we'll talk about include files today. And we'll talk about why they are so cool. So let's first of all talk about what we want our site to look like. All right, I'm not going to spend a lot of time making a site look pretty, but I do want to design it with sort of a thought in mind of what it's going to look like. And what it's going to look like, to sort of sketch out the wireframe, would be something like this. We have my banner on the top of the page. We have navigation here. I'm going to have the page's content here. And finally, I'm going to have a footer here. So real basic design. But I want all my pages to look like that. All right. Now, if you remember when we did HTML, those of you that took CISS 2:16, we talked about making a template for your web pages. And we talked about putting your CSS in an external file. And the problem that we had is our CSS is already in an external file. So if we had to make a change to that, we could make that change in only one place, and that change would be reflected throughout the site. So if our page was red and white, let's say, and we decided that we wanted a darker shade of red for the things that were red, we wouldn't have to go into every individual page because that code to get that appearance would be in the CSS. So we'd only need to go into the CSS file and change the color from red to darker red. All right. So that was really, really good. All right. The problem we had was with HTML, because we drew wireframes like this in CISS 2:16 as well. And we coded our banner, we coded our navigation, and we coded our footer, and those were sort of the common areas. They were the same on each page. What was different on each page would be this, the content area. So we'd have a home page and a contact us page and a customer review page or whatever. But the content area would be different, but these things would be the same. The problem just using basic HTML is, though, we could create a template, we could clone it, but if we decided to go back and change any of these, after we clone those pages and made duplicates of those pages, copied the template, if we changed any of these sections, we'd have to go back and change each individual page. That was kind of a pain. All right. We sort of wished that we had something like CSS where we could put a block of code in a file and then simply use that file throughout our site. And that is what an include file is. An include file is where we can take a block of code, we can put it in a separate file, and then we can use that file throughout our application, throughout our site. All right. The big advantage of that is, let's say we decide that we want to include a picture in our banner, and we didn't originally. If we have 100 pages on our site, we don't have to go into all 100 of them and code that image. We can put that in the include file, all right, and then we simply change the include file. And then all the pages that use that file will get the change. So that's what we're going to start out doing today. All right. Our fitness site is going to have, we're going to call it Planet Zellers. All right. Thought long and hard about this. Planet Zellers, fitness for programmers. And right now, we're going to have three pages. All right. We're going to have a home page. We're going to have a heart rate chart. And then we're going to have a heart rate calculator. And the content page is going to be different for each of the pages. The home will just have some text talking about us. The chart will have a chart of the optimal heart rate range for your exercising. The calculator will allow you to type in your heart rate for 6 seconds, and then it will do the math to figure out what your heart rate per minute is, and then it will tell you if you're in or out of the acceptable range. And the footer will just be, you know, something copyright, that sort of thing. All right, let's talk a little bit about your heart rate when you're exercising. In what range should your heart rate be when you're exercising? Does anyone know?
I didn't know. I mean, I knew there was a range. I looked it up on the way here.
Depends on
your
age.
Depends on your age. Right. All right.
Actually, here's a formula. Here's a formula that I found on, I think, American Heart Association. So there might be a little bit different formulas, but the basic range is something like this. You take 220 minus your age. And that is your maximum heart rate. When you are exercising, you should be 50 to 85% of your maximum. Chart is going to be, is it's going to be your age, let's, we'll, just for fun, we'll do it in increments of 5, all right, there'll be the range that it should be, so the range 20-year-old would be, all right, 220 minus 20 is 200, so 50% of 200 would be 100, 85% of 200 would be 170. And the maximum would be 200. And we'll have that all the way down. All right, now, our heart range checker will put in how many beats in 6 seconds. I know this is, some of the stuff, you know, with Fitbit and all this sort of thing, it's a wonder they even, like, still say this, because, like, you have an app that can do that for you, but we'll pretend it's 2010 or something, and we'll do this site. All right, so you put in your beats per 10 seconds, or 6 seconds. You put in your age. We would then like something that would say, yes, you are in range. Or no, you are not. We might want more than that. We might want to see what the max, what your actually beats per minute is, which would simply be this times 10. We might want to see your maximum based on your age, and we might want to see the range again. Now, a little warning buzzer should have gone off in your head. All right? We have the same sort of calculations on two different pages, right? Obviously, this page and this page
calculate the range for your age. All right. Both this page and this page needs to calculate a maximum for your age. All right. This one needs to do a little bit more. It needs to say whether your range is within the range or not. All right. So, whenever you hear something's going to be in more than one place, immediately your mind should think of how can I put it only in one place? You know, if something is needed in several different places, immediately the question is how can I code this so I'm not duplicating my efforts? And I just sort of let on the solution to this, and it's going to be an include file. So we're going to have an include file that's going to have functions to calculate your maximum heart rate, your lower number of your range, the high number of your range. And we might throw in a couple other functions in there too. All right, we'll see. Now the nice thing is we can then include this in any of the pages that we have throughout this site. All right, because we have at least two pages that need it, maybe more need it. All right, so onward and upward. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to build our include files in our home page. All right, again, our job isn't to make it look real pretty, but I will spend a little bit of effort here to make it look like a complete site. All right. How many include files do you think I'm going to have when I'm done with this? When I'm done with this, those three pages. I know we didn't talk about the details of include files, but I sort of mentioned what an include file is. How many do you think we're going to end up with?
I missed what it was. So.
Then pick an integer.
Five.
I was going to say pick an integer greater than zero, because I wouldn't be talking about it if it was, no, we're not going to use include files. Just joking. And, I don't know, a million seems too high. So you said five. It's actually not a bad guess, five. One? All right. I am thinking we're going to end up with four. All right. Here's the four include files I think I'm going to have. Because I'm thinking this in terms of blocks. All right. Blocks that we want to duplicate. We probably could get by with, I'm not sure about one, but we probably could get by with maybe one or two. We probably could. But I'm going to do it in four. All right, what do you think those four are going to be? I'm going to have an include file for the header. I'm going to have an include file for the navigation. I'm going to have an include file for the footer. All right, so those are the three. Could I put those all in one include file? Maybe. But by treating them as components or blocks that I could move around, that's going to increase my flexibility. All right. And where's the fourth one going to be? The fourth one's going to be the functions and the calculations. Now, could I include that include file? Could I include that code in one of the other include files? Yeah. But it's sort of nice to think in modular terms, to think this is the block of code that has that. All right. We're sort of separating it into little files. Each file has one purpose. All right. So, yes, we could combine them, and we could come up with one or two, maybe, but I'm going to have a block. I'm going to have an include file for each sort of component that I'm going to plug into my page. So let me go and let me create my home page without an include file. And I'm going to do it in PHP. And right now this page is not going to have any dynamic code at all in it. All right, it's going to be all HTML. But that's okay, because PHP can be all HTML. Right? Now what can I put in an include file? I can put anything in an include file that I could put in a PHP page. So I could put CSS, I could put JavaScript, I could put HTML, I could put PHP. So anything that I can legally put in a PHP page, I can put in an include file. So let me start out here. I'm going to start out doing this as though I never heard of include files.
So. There's my header section. My nav section. It's going to have three links for the home page. By default, many web servers want the home page to be called index.php. Many web servers by default are configured so that if you don't supply a page name, it looks for index.php. So if you went to planetzellers.com and you didn't supply a page, it would look for index.php. So I'm going to call my homepage index.php. And we'll see that in a second. Now, we have our two other pages. Our navigation. Here we go. So there we go. And I'm going to go and I'm going to copy this over to my web server. Make sure that it works. So I'll go and save this as. Oh, I forgot the content area. This is going to be the part of the page that's going to be different for every page. Save this as index.php. I'm going to put it on the desktop. Then I'm going to go in and copy that over to where my web server is expecting the files, which is CINETPUB www.root. So I'm going to delete all these. And I'm going to copy this guy over. Now, to run this, how do I run it? I type in the name of the server, which is localhost. And if I put in the name of the file, that's fine. And there's our page. Didn't get the copyright thing right.
because it's not an at sign, it's a tilde. So let me go correct that. Not the tilde. It's not the at sign, it's the ampersand, rather. That's not a tilde. What am I thinking? Now, depends how this web server is configured or not. If I type in localhost, if the web server is configured correctly, it'll bring this page up. I have a feeling this web server, because it's Microsoft IIS, I have a feeling it's not expecting PHP files, so it'll probably give me an error. I stand corrected. It is expecting PHP files, and it gave me the home page. All right. Now, I'm not going to spend tons of time doing the CSS to this, but I am going to do a little bit of work just to make it look a little bit better, like a completed site. So I'm going to create a new file. I am going to say body. One thing I think that one thing that I kind of like to do sometimes on sites is just change the type from black to like a dark gray. I think that's a cheap and quick and dirty way to give a little bit of a more quite a little less harsh, and it still has a good contrast, and it looks a little nicer in my opinion. And I'll do font family of Helvetica, Arial, Sans Serif.
It's the exact same font family I use on everyone.
That's the same font family that everyone uses.
It's so pretty.
On everyone, yeah. There's actually a movie on, I think it's still on Netflix, called Helvetica, that talks about Helvetica as being the perfect font. So, and Arial, of course, is Microsoft's version of Helvetica. So, if you really want to have a fun night watching movies, watch Helvetica. So I did that for the header. I'm not spending much time talking about this. The CSS, the assumption is that you know this. If you don't and you have a question about something, by all means ask. Even though it's not explicitly the purpose of this class, one nice thing about this is that we can spend some time reviewing some stuff. The other thing is I'm going to get rid of those bullet points, and I'm going to make the links be oriented horizontally, but only in the nav section. So I'm going to say nav li display inline block. Save this on the desktop. I will call it main.css. I'll put in here
So, hey, not bad. Something looks weird. We're not going to obsess about it right now. Like, why doesn't that line up with that? Alright, I said I'm not going to obsess about it, so I'm not. If anyone sees what's wrong with it, let me know. Even if you see after class. Nice thing about this design is it's very basic. Even if we were on a mobile device, which we can simulate by going to here. Doesn't look bad. I guess it doesn't look particularly good, but we could make it look better. All right. Now, include files. Remember, what's going to be common on every page? This is going to be common. This is going to be common. This is going to be common. So I'm going to break each one of those up and put them in their own include file. And again, I could combine things. I could put all of these in one and just play with my CSS to drop the footer down a little bit, but, or I could combine header and nav, but I'm going to make each one a little plug-in standalone component. One thing to keep in mind when you're creating a component, and by a component I mean a lot of different things in software development. You know, an include file is a component. You can just plug it in place and there you go. A class in other programming is a component. A function in a way is a component, all right, a part of a component. A lot of times your best option is to make the component do one thing instead of combining things. And you can almost tell if you give your component a name that has the word and in it, that maybe it would be better off as two components. So I could put all of these in a single include file, and my include file I'd call header and nav. Oh, well, there's the word and in it, so maybe it'd be better to create a header component and a nav component. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this code. That's what an include file is. It's a snippet of any kind of PHP code. Could be PHP, could be HTML, could be JavaScript, could be CSS, could be anything that's legally into a PHP page. So I'm going to go and I'm going to save this as, I don't know if they have an option for that, so I'm going to save it as header. .inc. I'm going to do the same thing for the other two sections. it actually kept those other two open. So let me go and open them again. So there I am, my three include files. Right now they're all HTML, but that's okay, because an include file can contain anything that's in a PHP page. Now I have to, on my main page, I have to include that include file. Alright? How do I include it? Well, first of all, there's nothing in HTML directly that allows me to include it. So I have to go into PHP mode. And include, to include an include file, you type in the word include. Couldn't see that coming, could you? And then you type in the name of the include file. Now, if you remember right, what do I want to appear here? I want the header followed by the navigation. So I can just include both of those include files right here. Finally, to include the footer at the bottom after the section, I can go after the section and paste the include file. Let me save this, make sure I've done everything right, and then we'll talk more about it. So I'm going to copy everything over into here. And there I am. Looks exactly like it did before. All right, except the PHP includes include files, which allow me to now go and create a second page that looks exactly like the first page. All right. Now, remember, if I look at the code to get sent to the browser, all I see is the HTML, right? Because the PHP, the web server, processes that page and includes the include files. How does the web server handle an include file? It's like the web server copies and pastes that file to write that spot in the HTML code. So, this stuff here is not in PHP, so it gets sent directly to the client as is, without any processing. So this gets sent, that gets sent, that gets sent, that gets sent, that gets sent. We are now in PHP mode. It says include header.inc. What the server does is it finds that file, takes the contents of that file, and pastes it right here, and then goes continuing delivering it to the client or processing it or whatever it needs to do with the contents of the include file. So that's why header is before nav, because the include file for header is before the include file for nav. And that's why the footer is after the section, because the include file is after that, so it gets pasted right there. Questions. All right. This was fun. Let's make a second page. Let's make the page with the chart in it. All right. So I'm going to go. I'm going to copy this. Call it chart. I copied all of them. I'm going to do this one. I'm going to call this guy the chart. I'm not going to make the chart yet, but I'm going to start the chart. So right now I'll just have the H1 and the H2 on this page. I'll save it, and I'll copy it back to the web server. Now if I go and view this page, if I click on chart, I get the heart rate chart. I can go back to home and so on. Now, if I realize I forgot something in one of the include files, like my header, I want to say that in my header. I forgot my tagline. I spent thousands of dollars for a marketing organization to come up with that tagline, and I forgot to put it in there. Well, we only have to put it in the include file. All right, and again, we only have 2 pages at this point, but you can imagine us having 100 pages, and it would work the same way. Yes?
It doesn't really matter, but you forgot your
closing tag. I definitely forgot my closing tag, and it does matter. So I will go and copy it from the desktop to here. And now both pages have that change. So we're just like the CSS code, where if I need to change something in those common areas, I only need to change the one place. Questions about this? All right. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start making my fitness chart. So my fitness chart is going to have in it a for loop, right? Why a for loop? Well, because my chart is going to be a table, just like my table in my previous example. It's going to have a row for a 20-year-old, 25, 30, 35, I don't know, maybe we'll go up to 80, let's say. All right? And the mechanism for creating each row is going to be the same, right? We just need to plug in the actual values for a 20-year-old, a 25-year-old, and so on. Now, I'm going to practice what I preach here, all right? Because the one thing I preach is about doing a little bit of the code at a time, testing it, revising it, testing it, revising it, testing it. When you do that, that has a huge advantage of if you made a mistake, the mistake more than likely is going to be in the last round of lines that you changed. All right? Not always. Sometimes there's a mistake that just simply doesn't show itself until later. So I won't say 100% of the time. But if I have 10 lines of code and it works, if I add 3 more lines of code and all of a sudden it doesn't work anymore, there's a real good chance it's the 3 lines of code that I just added. All right? The other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pretend a little bit. All right? What do I mean pretend? I mean if I'm not ready to do the complete calculation, I'm going to like put a stub of a calculation in. I'm going to put like a partial part of the calculation in. So for example, I might hard code some values just to check to make sure my loop works, that my loop goes from 20 through 80. So I might not actually do the calculation of heart rate for a 20-year-old, 30-year-old, 40-year-old, and so on. But at least I'll see, yeah, the loop works and I get rows for 20 through 80. So that's what I'm going to do. That say to do? It says start off age at 20. Start out age at 20. Do this as long as age is less than or equal to 80, and each trip through the loop add 5 to age. Now I'm going to pop out of PHP mode because I'm just going to write some basic HTML right now. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put my table tag outside of here. I'm going to create a TR that contains some THs. Each time through the loop, I'm going to create a TR. Notice this is outside the PHP land. I'm going to pop into PHP mode to print the age. What did I do wrong up in my loop? We got the dollar sign in front of age. And yeah, right now I'm just going to write the word range and max. Because it's almost quitting time, right? I'm not ready to do the actual calculation yet. I am, though, going to put my end table tag. Now, again, notice how I'm going in and out of HTML. All right, up through here is just a basic HTML page, other than the includes. I start my table and I define the first row within HTML. I then go into PHP and create a loop. So that loop is going to repeat this section of code for as many times as the loop says to do it. Now that section of code, I've gone out of PHP for, and I'm back in HTML mode. So this is going to be, this block of HTML will get repeated one time for every trip through the loop. I then go back in PHP simply to finish the bracket to have that sort of to include that block of code as part of the loop. I'm going to save this. And then I'm going to copy. Chart back into here. I get an error. Yeah. Why didn't it give me parentheses? It gave me curly brackets. You're absolutely right. or not. For age equals 20, age less than or equal to 80, age equals age plus 5. Alright. These are lines of code that I've added. If I take them out, does this work? It does. So, I know the problem is with these lines of code. For sine age equals 20, sine age one thing that is we're at a disadvantage here is it's not showing me the error message. We talked about that last time. Unfortunately, that change we have to make every time because these machines have deep freeze on it. What I will do is I will figure out what's wrong. We will review changing the error, and I will post the corrected. I'll post a corrected version and show you how to re-enable the error and so on next time. And then we'll continue from there. All right, we'll see you over.